Chapter 13. Mandela. Ingrid, your good friend Victor is about to enter the diner, Max offers up unsolicited. Ingrid turns to see her tall blonde, blue-eyed Aryan friend of old, Victor Voss, coming through the front door. She jumps up and runs to greet him. Vic, so glad to see you, what are you doing here, how did you know where to? Come, sit with us, over here. Victor joins them at the booth then gets right to it, you are both in extreme danger, there has been a mishap at CERN. We are all in for a roller coaster ride, but the brakeman's pull has broken. Bob at first enraptured by Victor's sheer beauty, a masterful creation of flesh and bone, a work of art in his own right, then sinks into a disturbing scene where Victor and Ingrid may have more between them than just a cordial professional relationship. Bobby, Victor has something intensely important to share with us, listen closely, Ingrid calling Bob to attention. Robert, there has been a major accident at the CERN facility, you are familiar with CERN, aren't you? Bob shakes his head yes. CERN recently broke through the quantum barrier, we were able to see through to the other side, through the veil. Bob's brain started to percolate. 76. There has been a break in the space-time continuum, a splitting, we are about to experience, everyone on Earth will experience a shift in time, a quantum leap. Koth is ready. Bob sinks into a state of blinding bliss. Bobby, this sounds crazy I know, but stay with us here. Victor has one more thing to tell you, this is the most important message he is bringing to us tonight. The timeline has shifted, and we need to act fast. You need to open the next folder tonight. It cannot wait until Frankfurt. I must go now so your friends do not see any more than they need to. Go to this address tonight, I will be waiting there. Knock 3 times, then 6, then 9, Charlie will let you in. Victor gives Ingrid a big kiss on the cheek then hurries out, brushing shoulders with Magnus, as they pass each other through the doorway. Who was that guy? Magnus consents to Ingrid as he rejoins the table. You guys are not going to believe this, Hikaru jumping into the booth panic-stricken, bunching up with the others, then muzzles covertly, the man in the black coat is sitting in the back corner booth, in this very diner, with 3 other guys. Hikaru looks to Bob, Bob looks to Ingrid, Ingrid looks to Magnus, they all look to Hikaru, don't look at me, I'm just the messenger. What should we do, Ingrid? Magnus passions. Look, everyone remains calm, I will think of something. 77. Who gets the meatloaf? Says the waitress delivering their service. We need to finish eating then I have an idea, now eat, Ingrid demands then dives into her Caesar salad. This food is so filling, just like me mum's old home cooking, Bob reminiscing. I'm full, Hikaru belches out. Shouldn't we get out of here now? Magnus squirms. Bob leans over to Ingrid and whispers a whisper, we need Max, I'll call him from the bathroom stall and see what else he knows or can find out. Ingrid cups her hand to Bob's ear, what if they see you, it might be dangerous. Bob agrees. Excuse me miss, could we please get a doggy bag for the leftovers? I'll bring that right back, with your check. Gracias, Bob nods to the server. What are you guys hushing about? Magnus interjects. We are formulating a plan, bear with us Magnus. Ingrid found herself stuck between 2 worlds, one where she played the all-seeing, nurturing, mothering, girlfriend hopeful for Magnus, while plotting and planning to engage in an act of international espionage and intimacy with Bob. 78. Here's your check. I'll grab that when you're ready. Ingrid, Bob cups to ear, I will step out and make the call in the alley. I'll be right back. Here's a Benny, take care of the bill and tell the boys we will head back to the hotel from here. Tell them all is good. We can tuck them in and then go meet with Victor. Bob grabs the doggy bag, states his mission, then steps out into the alleyway. What a guy, caring for the less fortunate, delivering to a poor homeless man in need, our daily leftovers. Ingrid takes a deep breath then exhales through her puckered lips and recites a silent prayer. Max? Max? Are you there? I am right here, Bob. There you are, thanks Max, Bob held up his phone as he steps further into the shadows of the alley and points it towards the area where the dumpster was. Wait a minute Max, we have a problem here, where the hell did the dumpster go? Where is the old guy that lives in this alley? Bob was now standing right, where he had passed the old man, the dumpster was gone, and so was the old man. Bob, you heard what Victor said, there has been a crack, a break, a shift and many things will start to seem out of place. What we remembered to be real in memories, will no longer exist. The man and the dumpster are still where you left them, but in a new dimension, a new timeline, they exist now and only there. You are moving with many others into this new reality, Like the split of a zygote, it is a new rebirth. 79. Max, we need your help. What more can you tell me about the man in the black coat? He's with the Russians, am I correct? Ingrid could probably tell you more about him than I, but here's what I know. His name is Vladimir Horchkov. He is a Russian agent. He is no gentleman. He is working with Sophie the robot. They are trying to prevent an event from ever happening. This event, if carried to fruition, will set them back 50 years. What event, Max? What are we talking about? You're not ready to know that yet, Bob. Go back with your crew and send the boys to bed, then go meet with Victor. He will provide all the answers you seek. Thanks, Max. Bob pockets his phone. Max, are you hungry? I'll just leave this here for you, the rats, or whoever. He then heads back out front, seeing Ingrid waving him on to hurry. Let's go, Bobby. I did my good deed for the day. You should have seen his face light up when I gave him the bag. Bob looks over to Ingrid as if to say, I don't like being a liar, but sometimes. We can deal with this spy guy later. Ingrid pushes them back into motion. 80. As they were heading back to the convention center hotel, help, I'm stepping into the twilight zone. The place is a madhouse, feels like being cloned. My beacon's been moved under moon and star. Where am I to go now? I've gone too far. Rang out from the Americana graffiti diner jukebox, tapering off into the stillness of the night, as they crossed the intersection at La Rambla and Passeig de Gracia. Hopeful eyes peered in and out of the shadows along the way, searching for clues where there were none, safely making their way back to Chess Champ Camp. Twilight Zone tilde by Golden Earring.